Morning. With a few buildings against the walls and a keep in the middle that became a castle in the course of the 15th century. And then a palace with the Renaissance or the Renaissance or here. Salt on the road ice. And anyway, with winter tires, you can drive on snow and road ice. Really, be careful. So now you're used to that. Where are you from? Southern. Various reasons at that time they started rediscovering the antiquity, mythology. So Heidelberg became Lutheran for the third time officially under him. Actually, 30 odd years after Martin Luther, it took quite a while before they decided to be Lutheran. Now, what does Renaissance mean in the case of that facade? There's a word on the conversation, but this one, architectural language. It's difficult. So, those pilasters or half columns, the little capital, the gables above the window, those are considered first difficulty is the mixture of mythological and biblical inspirations. Three statues. Starting from left hand side, the first room. Castle as it was at that time, that implied maintaining ruins. And those ruins you see in the whole northern facade, you see it led up and downtown, are the first examples of the ruins maintained as such. You know? What I find interesting, fine, somehow, is that at the same time, we were faced with bricks were.
The sundial. Most famous drunkard of Heidelberg's history.
It's Frederick. Did I get the top of the song?
That one is 14,000 liters.
You notice that all such hotels that are doors that are on the room side, and they say that anybody goes through the door. One, the hard part is through the soft part. And they say they enter with a candle. Some say the centurion side.
Let's go walk up there.
Yeah.